Good afternoon, everybody. This is Brother Lloyd. I hope you're all having a blessed and wonderful day. And for all my Sabbath keepers, I hope you had a blessed and peaceful Sabbath yesterday, as I did. It was a wonderful and beautiful day. Now to the topic at hand, liars. And the study is titled, You're a Liar, Just Like Your Father. And the problem with the liar and their lying is consistency. Consistency says a lot about your character, and your character will always reveal who you are. So a liar's character will eventually reveal who they are. Have you ever heard somebody say, or have you said, I cannot stand a liar? But that's okay, because the Most High says that a liar is one of the six things that he hates and abhors, Proverbs 16:19. And he also tells us in Proverbs 12:17 that a liar is only out to deceive. And I don't think any of us needed to hear the Most High's word to understand that. But understand this, it's in his word, and if he has commentary on it, it's an extremely serious matter. Because if he says he hates it and abhors it, we know that's another character or characteristic that he's not going to allow into his kingdom. Because like I said, people, once we die, we are who we are. Man can teach you and tell you whatever he wants. And what we go down as is what we're going to come up as. Now, Satan is the only proven perfect liar. Not that his lies are perfect. It's just been perfectly proven by the Most High's word that he's a liar. And he will never change. Now, individuals, they have flaws in their attempts to be a perfect liar. So eventually, they are revealed to us no matter how long it takes. Here's one of the things, though. Man likes to classify or term those who continuously lie as individuals with maybe a mental or some type of disorder. See, man always wants to apply his science to explain something scientifically as to justify it for our human minds. And people like to say that everything is a condition or illness or disorder. Many of these people are termed by man as pathological or compulsive liars, or a disorder or a mental condition. Now, a compulsive liar is described as someone who lies with ease and finds comfort in it. They're just comfortable lying, and they just flow out their mouth like average words for most people. Do you know any compulsive liars? Are you one? See, this person may even continue to lie when the truth is presented to them in cold, hard facts. This is a compulsive liar, according to man. Now, try to get a compulsive liar to admit that he or she has lied. They will take it to the grave, they say. Who says that? And who are they? Probably the other liars. Now, the other type of liar is called a pathological liar. And they can also be described as a habitual liar. This is the individual that just lies constantly for no personal gain and no reason sometimes. They just lie out of habit. It's a habit. They're a habitual liar. But it's called being pathological. And man says it's up here. It's in the brain. It's a disorder. It's a condition. And man goes through a lot to break down different types of liars, calling them disorders and conditions, illnesses and diseases. But the bottom line is, they're just a liar, according to the Father's word. Now, speaking of sleep paralysis, which is a video that I did a while back, and it still gets a decent amount of traffic, because a lot of people like to argue about demons, medical conditions, man science versus what the word says. But let me say this, without sin, I repeat, without sin, none of us would ever have any sickness or condition, physical or mental. All conditions and the result thereof are rooted in sin, which means sin allows for the sickness of the body and the mind to be manifest by the power and through the enemy, Satan, and his little minions, as we like to call them, demons. Now, any person in a weakened state, physically or mentally, is even more susceptible to attacks by the enemy. Understand this, people. This is a spiritual battle. They are spiritual beings. They have strength and power. Being sick under the influence of alcohol and or drugs, and this includes taking medications that are prescribed in a lot of instances, if they alter your mind and your thinking, your body, whatever the case may be, they make you susceptible to the enemy. Being depressed, sad, despondent, all those type of conditions, states of mind, are a breeding ground for the enemy, for the devil. The devil needs a way in. When we have cracks in our armor, physically or mentally, he can get in. See, we're so used to inviting him in through our mouth that we think that's the only way. That's not the only way. If our mind is weak, he's already in there suggesting temptation in the mind. Now, why do you think depressed people and people in altered states of mind do some of these horrific things, commit suicide, commit mass murders, whatever the case may be, and then afterwards they claim they are not able to remember? Now, if you just follow man's carnal type of thinking, they're just crazy, they're just this, they're just that. The bottom line is, if you are a believer, if you trust and understand and study the Most High's word, you will understand that these are nothing other than forms of possession by the enemy. If he can get in our mind and control us, he will, through himself or his demons. Now, if any of us knew the who, what, when, where, and why that brought on any of these sicknesses or conditions or illnesses or diseases, we'd really be on to something. The fact is, it is sin. Sin has degraded us physically and mentally from the beginning, and nothing's going to change. See, a believer is going to go by the Most High's word, and an unbeliever is going to go by man's science, and that's fine by me. See, we all seek to be comfortable and confident based on what we believe. I say demonic attack, you say medical phenomena or condition or disease or illness. I say you're a liar like your father Satan, and you say it's a mental condition called compulsive or pathological lying disorder. The point is, can you even see the deception in this by the enemy giving us yet another way to avoid calling sin by its rightful name? He will have us call it A, B, C, and D as opposed to calling it sin. And that's what it is. The Most High says that it is from Satan and it is sin. So I'm stuck on believing his word. And everyone else is free to choose whatever they will. Remember, you know, as I say, free will. Everybody has free will. So use yours wisely. So remember, a person who is living in sin, and we should all know this, is primed for attack by the enemy because they are already in his realm by choice. You're already in his house by choice. You're already sitting at his table by choice, eating of his food. He and his influence are like Dracula. If you don't invite him in, he can't come in. But if you do, next comes that bite that corrupts and poisons your blood and changes you to one of his, a liar, a cheat, an adulterer, a thief, a murderer, whatever. If we play with the devil, we will follow the devil and do his bidding. As simple as that. But I digress. Back to lying. Now, the truth of the matter is that lying is just plain old sin. Any condition or illness that comes from it is just a result of the sin in a manifested form at the hands of the enemy and by his power. Satan is the perpetrator of sin and has many of us following his lead. John 8:44 tells us that he's a liar and he's the father of it. But John 8:44 tells us so much more. There's always a lot of injustice done to the Most High's word by many of us who are always just paraphrasing parts of scripture to suit our purpose. So we're going to read the whole verse of John 8:44 so we can get the full context of what it really says. Ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Then it just adds so much more to it when you read the whole context of what 844 says, John 844. And also, let's be clear, and I mean crystal. Circumventing, skirting around, smudging, and definitely omitting, I repeat, omissions of anything other than telling the truth is a bald-faced lie. Let me repeat that. Circumventing, skirting around, smudging, and definitely omitting anything other than telling the truth is a bald-faced lie. Now, if someone doesn't ask the right question to receive the truth in a matter, and you conveniently don't tell them something because they didn't ask, it doesn't make you any less of a liar.
Liar.
In fact, it makes you even worse of a liar.
Liar.
Because you deceived them, because you conveniently misled them. And then you'll turn around later and say, well, you didn't ask. If you had asked, I would have told you.
Liar.
Lying is the devil's character, or Satan's character. Truth is the Most High's character. And the Most High simply says that from the beginning, Satan has cast man into death. He has never manifested any faithfulness because there has never been any in him. And when he speaks a lie, he speaks of his own mind, because it originates with him. Understand, people, the devil can be very convincing. And so can his followers. Do you know any of his followers? Friends, co-workers, family members, associates? Ever met any? Now, the devil never comes to us and directly say, listen, what I'm about to tempt you to do is a lie and will lead you down a path of destruction. Nah, he's very clever. He's very subtle. And he will do anything in his power to convince us that his way is best, and that the Most High's way is wrong. And this is no different than what people we know and some we love are trying to convince us to do when they're lying to us. Their way is right, and what we know to be right is wrong. And here's the deal. If we could even see for 1 second where he's leading us, we would never follow him. If we could see where that liar is trying to lead us for 1 second, we would never listen to him. But some of us keep listening to these same old liars over and over anyway, because we expect something different, or because they say, oh, I'm not lying this time. This is the truth. We willfully turn our backs to the truth and believe his lies. We willfully turn our back on the truth and believe their lies. It's no different, people. Satan's greatest lie is that we should believe him instead of the Most High. In the garden, he persuaded Adam and Eve to believe him instead of the Most High, and it led to their spiritual death. What were those words spoken in Genesis 3, verse 4? Then the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not die at all. But God doth know that when ye shall eat thereof, your eyes will be open, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. Really? Can you see Eve's face now going, really? She thought about it. See, the devil's subtle and smooth in his words. That lying friend, family member, co-worker, associate, whomever, they make you go, oh, really? Satan's chiefest, his highest, his most prized subtlety is to cause us not to fear the word of the Most High, not to fear his warning, not to fear his threatenings to us that he attaches to his words. If you do this, the Most High says, this is what's going to happen to you. But yet, the devil comes along and says, oh, don't worry about that. It's going to be all right. You won't get in trouble. That sounds like people you know, doesn't it? Ain't nothing but the devil. In the wilderness, he tried to deceive our Savior, Yeshua, into following him instead of the Most High. And he was so subtle as to quote scripture, although he didn't quote all of it. Now, isn't that just like a liar to not tell all the truth, but just enough to get you to go the way they want you to go? Boy, I'm telling you, the devil is a liar and the truth ain't in him. And so is that person you're listening to that misleads you and gets you to do something foolish or wrong. I'm telling you people, in the last day, the word says that Satan's followers will end up being deceived. Well, we all know this. But the problem is, these same individuals are going to be deceiving others. 2 Timothy 3:13. If we don't listen and study the Most High's word, these same people that we listen to now, that you don't cut off in whatever terms, these same individuals are going to lead you to damnation with them. Those of us with liars in our midst, we need to be very careful of what we let these known liars put in our ear, especially if we know they aren't living right. If you know individuals aren't living right, and you are or are striving to, and you know they're not, why do you listen to them? And here's the deal. You have to be extra diligent. If some of these known liars are your children, your husband, your wife, family members, your BFF, or whomever, people close to you, you better be very diligent if you know they are known to lie. Don't cover it up and deny it. Always have both eyes open, both ears open, and take what they say with some serious consideration. Now, if this habitual liar or this person with this disorder is a friend of yours, why are they still your friend? Why are you still hanging on to them? What benefit are they to you? You have to learn how to cut certain people off at whatever level. Remember, bad company corrupts completely. It will corrupt you. You are not going to win over when you're trying to deal with a corrupt individual. Ultimately, you will be corrupted. And if you can't let them go, you know what that other saying is? It kind of goes, birds of a feather flock together, something like that. So, it says something about you and your character. If you're still hanging on to that lying friend of yours, you can't seem to let them go. It really does. It says something about your character. It's more of a you issue than theirs. We already know who they are, so why are you hanging on to them? Some of these same individuals are going to be the same ones, like I said, turning us in when legislation start passing laws like the mark of the beast and things like that. And then when the authorities start coming looking for individuals who aren't being obedient to man's corrupt law, these liars and misusers of words are going to say, they're over there, they live here, they live there. Why? Because they're going to be able to gain from it. Be very careful, people. Your best choice is to keep corrupt individuals at a controlled distance and out of your life altogether if possible. And I say that because some of these individuals are family members, so you have to deal with them accordingly. But you have to be wise in some of the things you do in terms of your dealings with them. 1 John 3:8 reads like this, he that committeth sin is of the devil. Once again, another scripture telling you that Satan is your father. For the devil sinneth from the beginning, for this purpose was made manifest that the Son of God, that he might loose the works of the devil. So once again, we're being told that someone doing as a devil is his child. Let me break 1 John 3:8 down like this. If you commit sin, you are ruled by the inspiration of the devil to serve sin. And if you be the devil's son or daughter, then you are not the Most High's son or daughter. See, the Father's word is clarifying whose child you are. Understand that, people. Satan has done nothing from the beginning but sin. So when we are lying, committing sin, we are merely resembling our father, Satan, the originator of sin. Mothers, don't you hate when your child lies to you? Where do they learn this, and who teaches this to them? I'm stepping on some toes now. Be very careful what you show and teach them, your children, in the home. Mothers, dads, don't show them one thing and do another, and then say, "Do as I say, not as I do." Another infamous phrase from the devil. You have to show them truth. You have to show them what's right. Don't lie in their presence and then say, "I don't want you to do that." Don't do something that's not right in their presence and say, "Don't do that." Because a child in their innocence will inevitably turn around to you and say, "But I saw you do it, Mommy. I heard you say it, Daddy." They're learning it, a lot of it, from the household. You have to put as much truth and righteousness in them as possible. So when they go out here in these corrupt school systems with other corrupt children, they understand right from wrong. And at every turn, when they come home, they will come home and say, "Mommy, Daddy, such and such and such and such said this or did that. That's not right." Believe me, it's possible, and I've seen it. We have to teach them what's right because the world's not going to do it. Look, some of you lie so much, people run when they see you coming. And the ones that do stay around, they're hanging around for the entertainment value to see what lies you're going to tell them next. Lying lips are an abomination to the Most High. Proverbs 12:22. We have to be very diligent and pay very close attention to individuals that we're going to put trust in. I don't care who they are, because if we become a respecter of person instead of the respecter of truth, it will cost you. It will cost you dearly. We all know that the Most High puts us all on the same level playing field, and He is no respecter of person, regardless of race, color, creed, position, title, or what have you. Romans 2:11. But know this, I am big on friends, and I use that term loosely, and family that do things that are done to cause you harm for their own personal gain. I don't care who it is. This is nothing but evil, and at some of the highest levels, because these individuals know you better than most. So when they do things like this to take advantage of you for their own personal gain, it's that much more egregious. All they care about is their gain and their benefit, and what they're really revealing is their unending selfishness toward you and what they're thinking about. They don't care about your feelings, your well-being, or what have you. They don't care about doing the right thing. They just care about self. Their only concern is satisfying their need and contriving a successful plan in gaining that objective. And their hope is that they don't get caught or called out by you. That's their only hope in all of it. See, but what happens when that liar is found out, when it's your husband or your wife or your son or your daughter or whomever, these close individuals? What happens when they're found out? Oh, now here we come with the fake tears. Oh, here we come with the slumped over, saddened posture of exposure. Oh, here we come with the insincere apologies. Oh, here we come with the promises restitution and that I'll never do it again and oh, I'm so sorry. Really? What? How can a liar promise you anything? How can a liar promise you anything? How can you even listen? But see, the sad thing is, for most people it's okay because after all, they are your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, your husband, your wife, your best friend, or that close associate. Many of us are still allowing ourselves to be deceived and lied to by some of the same people that are extremely close to us. But yet, we'll rebuke and chastise and criticize and skepticize that politician that got busted doing something, that pastor that got busted doing something, that athlete, this person and that person. But we fail to look to our right and left right beside us and see that family member that's so close to us that lied to us not 5 minutes ago, not a day ago, not a week ago. And we just forgive them over and over again. Does Judas come to mind? We hug these individuals and we love them and they kiss us right on the cheek. Does Judas come to mind? They're going to be kissing us on the cheek, this side, that side, and turning us over to the governments and the officials and everybody else. Be very careful, people. The Most High is constantly teaching us that allowing these Judases in our midst will only lead to us being deceived, persecuted, and even crucified as we get closer to the last days, just like they did our Savior, Yeshua. Be very careful. We must deal with the Judases or the liars in our life now and wisely, or they're going to deal with you when it's all said and done. Remember, we're no challenge for the sophistries of the devil. He's subtle, he's smooth, and he's going to use those closest to you to deceive you. Revelation 22:15 reads, "For without shall be dogs and enchanters and whoremongers and murderers and idolaters and whosoever loveth or maketh lies." They're going to be without. So here's my warning to some of you. Don't become known as a liar and cheater of people. Now, that may work out well in the company of fools and liars, but the rebuke from the wise and the righteous will call you out and will call sin by its rightful name. And remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.